Hello everyone and welcome back to my F1 2020 My Team career mode journey for the round in Canada today. We are going to start off with an upgrade to the energy store durability and then we'll get straight into qualifying. So let's get into it. So Canada then. Never been my best track on the calendar, but I've still had some decent races here in the past, so let's hope that we can have another one today and hopefully at least get out of Q1 in this first session. So here we go on what is our third flying lap in qualifying. The first two were on the same set of tyres. This one is on a brand new set, so I imagine we should be able to improve on our original times quite significantly. So as we head through the first sector, you can see we are gaining a pretty significant amount of time, and we go green to the first sector, and if we can carry that through to the end of the lap, we will improve beyond what is currently the back row of the grid, so through the wall of champions section, and just about getting through there, hopping over the curbs a little bit to get the lap time in. But as we cross the line, we go 14th, and by the time everyone else sets their lap, we are down out of Q2, unfortunately for us, down in 17th. So yeah, not great for us, and we also have a penalty for a collision with another car in that session. So not a great start to the weekend. We'll be starting from the back, so yeah, it's not great. So starting from the back anyway, and the other thing is I also messed up the engines, and I was running the practice engine in that qualifying session, so this will start us from the back of the grid to put a new engine in. It's not a brand new engine, it's just the one that we have been using, and well, also all the other components, turbo and MGUK, MGUH, etc. But anyway, let's get into the race.
Bonjour, it's time once again to go racing here in Montreal, the second largest French-speaking city in the world, and home since 1978 to the Canadian Grand Prix. With top speeds of around 210 miles per hour heading into the overtaking opportunity of turn 13, the 2.7 miles of the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve are some of the quickest on the Formula One calendar. There are 14 corners in total, with 60% of the lap taken at full throttle, and average lap speeds clock in at about 130 miles per hour. And I'm joined once again by Anthony Davidson to bring you the lowdown for today's race. So, let's briefly discuss Lewis Hamilton. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
It's always nice to come into a Grand Prix weekend on a high, but your expectations are based much more on your practice and qualifying runs. So it's the momentum from those sessions that they'll be hoping to carry into the race today.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Vettel, Verstappen, Carlos Sainz, and Ricciardo, Albon, Perez, Giovinazzi, and Kimi Raikkonen, Stroll, Ocon, Charles Leclerc, and Grosjean, Latifi, Gasly, Daniel Kvyat, and Lando Norris, Russell, Joe, Magnussen, and the scientist. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track and get this Grand Prix underway.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
So there's not too much to look at in terms of strategy, as you can see on the weather indicator about half an hour into the race. It'll be raining, so we're just going to start on the softs and see how it goes. So let's go. Five red lights, and lights are out. We are underway for the Canadian Grand Prix. A lot of wheel spin for Guan Yu Zhou, but he's made an alright start. We find our way to the inside line to see if we can make a dive on a few cars into the first corner. We do just that down the inside of Latifi, but he squeezes us right off circuit there, and we have to leave him some space to retake the position, and we will live to fight another day on that one. And as we have another look down the inside into turn three, not going to work out for us there. and we just have to wait our turn, and it might come very soon down the inside into the middle sector, and we get the move done on the Williams driver. But he's actually still alongside us, and he may come back at us on the right here, and he does. So it's going to be side by side as we head towards the next chicane. He's going to have the inside line. He pulls through straight away with that Mercedes engine, very powerful. We switch back though down the inside and make the move back on Latifi. So a lot of squabbling, and Leclerc seems to be struggling in these opening phases, because we're having a look to the outside of him as he's stuck in traffic, and we make the move on the Ferrari, and he's really struggling now. And now Latifi is having a look to try and overtake Leclerc. So Leclerc going backwards significantly in this race, already losing a few positions. I think he'll hold off Latifi for the time being, but yeah, he has really struggled in this opening phase of this race. He is also on the medium tyres, that is worth noting, and that could be why he is having some issues in this race, as he tries to overtake us again, and again he doesn't make the move work. And here comes Latifi once again trying to overtake him, but I think once again the Ferrari power will allow Leclerc to stay ahead there and maintain the position. But he really needs to get a move on to get back where that Ferrari should be. But anyway, we move on, and you can see we're catching up to Pierre Gasly in the AlphaTauri. Let's see if we can make a move on him into potentially the first corner, but a bit of a mistake there for us through the wall of champions section, and Leclerc is going to take that opportunity straight away on the left-hand side, and he overtakes us with no trouble there in that Ferrari. But it might not be the worst thing, because we might be able to follow him through the traffic, and basically he can just tow us along. So here is the first example of that. Leclerc trying to make the move around the outside of Gasly, and we'll see if we can take advantage of it as well. We're late on the brake to try and get alongside. It doesn't really work out for us there, but we've got DRS and Gasly does not. And we go to the outside once again as we head towards the first corner, and we'll make the move around the outside and overtake Gasly for 15th position. So if that can continue, this could work out very well for us if we can follow Charles Leclerc through the field. But unfortunately, Leclerc is not really making the moves that I hoped he would. And by the time we move on to lap 9, we're in a big train here. Leclerc behind Grosjean, and a whole bunch of cars in just a DRS train ahead of him. So we just need to overtake these cars. The time for waiting is over, so we have a look on Charles Leclerc. Doesn't work out for us.
Okay, we don't think we're far away from some rain. I'll keep you updated as the conditions change.
And now rain is inbound, it seems. So, yeah, we really need to get a move on now. Otherwise, we're just going to be stuck in a wall of spray when
okay,
the rain comes.
Is catching you by 5/10 a lap. 5/10.
And just to add to that, Gasly is now closing up on this train once again. So it's all heating up at this point in the Canadian Grand Prix. Speaking of heating up, we're going to go for the move down the inside of Leclerc into the first corner. And very aggressive and spontaneous, but we do make it work and move ourselves up into 14th. Next up is Grosjean, but first we'll have a look at a replay of the move on Leclerc. Just sends it down the inside. Leclerc did not see it coming. Thankfully, he didn't damage his front wing turning in there, but we got the move done. Fairly enough there. Next up, as I said, is Grosjean down the inside into the wall of champions chicane, and that was easy enough to get past the Haas driver there, and we just move ourselves up into 11th position now, as several cars make pit stops in this race. So potentially some worn tyres from qualifying making them effectively take an extra pit stop, because we need one for intermediate tyres soon as the rain begins to set in.
We're still on the right tyres for the time being.
As we get past the Renault of Esteban Ocon and move ourselves up now into the top 10, into the points in this race. So it seems like we have some very, very good pace at this point. Lance Stroll is the next car up ahead. So let's see if we can make a move on him, potentially into the wall of champions. Chicane, we're so close behind him there, so slow through that hairpin now, as the greasy conditions worsen.
Conditions are going to keep deteriorating for 10 minutes at least. Dries seem like the fastest tyre at the moment.
Dries, still the way to go. So it's going to be a very tricky phase of the race as we try to chase these two down into the first corner. We may be close enough to Lance Stroll to make a move. It'll be late on the brakes. We do go for it though, and we move ourselves ahead of the Canadian at his home race, and ourselves up into what is now fifth position. Fifth position, as a lot of cars have gone in for an extra set of dries. Their soft tyres just not making it as far as they would have liked in the early stages, and that's really benefiting us and the people who started outside the top 10. But as we continue to push in this race, we are right behind the Alfa Romeo of Antonio Giovinazzi, and then it is Vettel and the two Mercedes, and that's it. That is the top five, and we go down the inside of Giovinazzi, and I don't really care about Lewis Hamilton, because we're up into P4. We're one place away from the podium. Admittedly, Vettel is a long way ahead. But it's time for the intermediate tyres.
Confirming that we'll be fitting the intermediate tyres.
And time to come into the pits. That starting phase of the race from last place up into P4 is absolutely insane. I did not expect anything like that to happen. So this race already has gone above and beyond any expectations that I may have had on the starting grid. I was thinking just to move forward.
Stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track.
And trying to move forward and getting into the top 15 would be a good effort. But at this point, we are looking good for some points. I think everyone else will come back at us though in the later stages. They have to. They've got the faster cars. But at this point, we seem to have some decent pace in this phase of the race. And as I mentioned in the past, the braking on this car is absolutely incredible as we go for a big slide from the first to the middle sector, and continues on for quite a few corners, just with no traction at this point, but still enjoying these conditions though. And okay, no team radio there apparently, but it is now actually time for the wet tyres, but I'm not going to take them. We're in a good position, and we need to take a risk here. And
gap to car in front is 29.6 seconds.
That is, or was, the gap to Vettel. He will be in soon for wet tyres, but I'm going to stay out on the intermediates because I've noticed in the past I've never liked the wet tyres. They overheat very, very easily. So I'm just going to stay on these intermediate tyres. That's two less pit stops that we have to make in this race. Tyre wear is not an issue for us on these intermediate tyres. I had a look at that too, and that won't be an issue. So we just need to keep things smooth and consistent. They won't be as fast.
The rain is getting lighter now, but it's going to take a while for the track to dry out. Inters and wets will probably have similar pace at the moment.
And with the rain lessening, I think that further proves that this is the right call. So we're going to remain in P4 when we're not close enough to Vettel.
Fourth position, you're in fourth position. Vettel is ahead of you. Okay, gap ahead is 6.9 seconds. They're on fresh wets. Giovinazzi is behind you. Okay, the gap behind is 13.3 seconds. They're on fresh wets. Your pit window opens in 15 laps time, 41 laps to go. A new strategy is available on the MFD.
So, as you heard, they're just under 7 seconds behind Sebastian Vettel. That gap will increase dramatically. Obviously, Vettel both being in the faster car and on the correct tyres.
11.4 seconds.
And even Giovinazzi catching up at multiple seconds just in that short time.
Got that confirmed.
But I think this is still going to be a net gain for us over the course of the race if we can make this work.
The rain's easing off a bit, but the track is still going to be wet for a while. Full wets seem like the best tyre for now. Gap to car in front is 9.4 seconds.
And there you go, you can already tell how much Vettel has gotten away from us. But as we continue on in this race, the conditions will eventually swing back around in our favour, and eventually it will swing back to intermediates and eventually dry conditions before the end of the race. So there's still plenty to play out in this one, but Vettel just seems out of reach. The rate that he's pulling away, I don't think we'll be able to jump him when he goes back onto the inters. I think he'll still be able to come out in front of us. That was my only hope for a podium, which was always going to be unlikely, but it was worth a throw of the dice. And either way, I still think we gained from not switching to the wet tyres. So
battery charge is high. Let's use that overtake button more.
So yeah, I think we made the right call. And at the end of the day, Giovinazzi is nowhere near us now, and he was quite close behind us before. And he actually was doing us a massive favour a while ago, holding up Max Verstappen, which is also quite helpful. But anyway,
20 plus to the car behind. 20 plus.
There you go, Jeff, confirming the gap back to Giovinazzi.
Radar is clear. Weather is looking good for now. Not sure whether dries or inters are faster. We're right on the crossover.
And just like that, nothing really was happening throughout those laps. And it's now time for the dry tyres. So on they go, medium tyres to the end of the race.
Go now.
And we...
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
We move off and continue our race and still maintain fourth position. I thought we may potentially get jumped on this one, but no, we are maintaining fourth and just need to defend it to the end of the race. So we move on then to the end of lap 46, so 24 laps to go when we cross the line, 23 actually, considering we are a lap down, so a long way to go. But Sebastian Vettel is in the pit lane. He's making an extra pit stop in this race, and that moves us up onto the podium and into third place in the Canadian Grand Prix. Sebastian Vettel comes out behind us on a new set of medium tyres. He was already on medium tyres before he made his stop, so I'm not sure why he made that stop, unless he got a puncture of some kind during that stint. But Sebastian Vettel with an extra pit stop drops him down to fourth, moves us up to third. I'll get it out eventually. And we are now on the podium, as we have to let Lewis Hamilton past with the blue flags there. Hamilton is absolutely dominating this race. Even ahead of Bottas, he had a huge gap, so no one is stopping him today, it seems, as Vettel has a look down the inside into the chicane. We leave him space, but he can't quite make the move. But two laps later, he's going to try the outside line into the hairpin. He gets a move done. We're going to be late on the brakes down the inside, but too late this time. Vettel's going to switch it back to the inside and draw alongside as we get a nice exit. And it's going to be a drag race towards the Wall of Champions. We're in the lead at the moment, but Vettel with the Ferrari engine is going to come back at us surely in the slipstream. He goes to the inside, and we're going to have to be super late on the brakes, leave him space. But we managed to stay ahead of the Ferrari driver for the time being. But it seems like every lap he gets closer and closer to making the move. Now it's the two Ferraris side by side as they head into the middle sector chicane, looking a little bit awkward there, but they managed to get away with it. Here's the onboard with Vettel. He almost drills the back of us there as he was trying to defend from his own teammate. So Vettel really not wanting to give up the fight in this one. And as you can see, he's going to come back at us once again to the inside as we're late on the brakes, trying to hold it around the outside, and a little bit off circuit, but we managed to get away with it and hold him behind for another lap. But this surely can't go on forever. Eventually, either Vettel or Leclerc will manage to get past us, but we're going to hold him off for as long as we can as they go down the inside once again. And he's around. Vettel has spun, and he is potentially out of the race if he connected with a wall. We'll have a look on board to see exactly how that ended, but thankfully for him, he managed to save it, only losing one position. So a little bit overdramatic there, but that has switched things around. Here's the onboard with Leclerc, who saw the whole thing and saw the C's part for him. He moves up into fourth. And now it's his turn to try to make the move on the inside of the same corner. And as he's done the same thing as Vettel, he's hit the right rear corner of my car and gone for a spin himself. And I don't think it ended quite as well for him. The spin was a little bit more aggressive, and then he drives straight into the wall. So there's that too. But I'm not sure what they're doing there. They go for a dive, and Leclerc gets disqualified for that, apparently. But anyway, I'm not sure what they're doing. They go for a move and then back out of it. Meanwhile, Sebastian Vettel overtakes us properly in this race. Not a lot we could have done about that. He eventually just sent it and made the move while Carlos Sainz retires from the race. So disappointing for the McLaren driver. He was running in a decent position in this one. But we move on. Send one down the inside of Vettel. And how on earth we got the car stopped and turned there, I will never know. But the car had more grip at that corner than I think it's had in its entire life. But somehow we made that move work. Just sent it down the inside. Vettel had no idea that we were coming. And probably scared himself out of the way there. But we got away with it. And that was borderline. But the move was on. And we managed to make it work. So crazy move there. But I think, again, it was just about fair enough. But as you can see, Vettel is not giving up. And in just a moment, you'll have an idea of what I'm dealing with every single lap with the straight line speed of that Ferrari. You can see next time we look back, there'll be a huge gap, and we're trying to break the slipstream to Vettel, which he's not really following us until we get to this second part of the straight. Now he is, and you can just see how much time that he gained there in the slipstream and through the chicane as well. We are not always too strong through there. But we managed to hold him off well on that occasion. But here he goes down the outside. Into the hairpin goes Vettel. We're all the way around the outside. We leave him the space. But he gets an absolutely dreadful exit. And we will not have to worry about him heading towards the chicane this time. But that was an aggressive move by Vettel. And a little bit of contact maybe going into the corner. And did he hit the wall there? Vettel may have grazed the wall on the exit. And that could spell trouble regarding his front wing. Let's see on board with him. He was very late on the brakes, and he does hit the wall. So Vettel will be very lucky to get away with that in terms of damage. But he does, and he goes for another move around the outside into the first corner. So Vettel not afraid to try a few different moves, but none of them are working out for him at the moment. So here he goes again to the inside of the first corner. And we're just gonna turn in on him. We didn't really see him coming there. He goes through a spin, and that might be damage to his car this time. As the conditions begin to have some rain in the air again. But there is the replay. Giovinazzi and Lance Stroll get through while he recovers there from the spin. That is Pierre Gasly watching on. He's on board with Vettel, and you can see he just again goes for that sort of half move. Is he going to do it? Is he not? And the indecisiveness really costing him there. If he just sent it down the inside, we would have been forced to leave him space. But anyway, Lance Stroll retires from the race from what was P5, so a disaster for him at his home race. Was looking good for a very solid haul of points and in a DNF for a mechanical failure. So very unfortunate there for Lance Stroll. So it's all kicked off in the closing stages of this race. But on the final lap of the race, we've only got Giovinazzi and Gasly to worry about. And Vettel has dropped well down the order after that spin. So after all that, we...
Okay, gap ahead is 55.3 seconds.
Wow, that is insane. The Mercedes are in a universe of their own. Hamilton is a lap up. He's almost a lap up on Bottas, let alone the rest of us. And Bottas is 55 seconds up the road from me. So we have got nothing against them at the moment. But what we do have, though, as we come through the final two corners...
There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
That. But we also now have a podium in Formula 1. Unbelievable. Last place to P3 in the Canadian Grand Prix. We got the driver of the day. can't think of any more rhymes. That is insane. That is huge for our championship and for the Constructors' Championship. 15 points in the bank.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team. And they certainly deserve it.
So, as I said, Lewis Hamilton takes the race win. Valtteri Bottas bringing home the 1-2. But it's P3 for us. Unbelievable.
So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Lewis Hamilton takes over the lead of the Drivers' Championship after an excellent result. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
I have to give it to the scientist. They did a great job at getting the most out of their tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern-day Formula One.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Another team that will be satisfied with this Grand Prix is Alfa Romeo, whose good result moves them further up the championship. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next one.
All right, P10 now in the Drivers' Championship. That is something crazy. Guan Yu Zhou had a very good race as well, 14th for him, 13th for Nicholas Latifi, flying the flag for the home favourites. But anyway, let's get into the interviews.
Great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. Who would you say is your biggest rival at the moment?
So for the rivalry, I chose Pierre Gasly. We managed to beat him today in a somewhat crazy race. But I think of all the options, I think he'll probably be the most beatable, given that we did kind of lose the last one with Magnussen, thanks to him getting away with a few dodgy overtakes in Azerbaijan.
How's your grid penalty going to affect your strategy going into the race?
Huh?
You gained a lot of positions during the race, didn't you?
Yeah, the car's been feeling absolutely fantastic this weekend. It was just really seems to stick to the road well.
Everything went your way today. It looked like you had a really good strategy for the race.
Yeah, not pitting for the wet tyres was a masterstroke by the team. So I'm very happy about that decision.
Appreciate your time.
So we get a bunch of acclaim for that podium, obviously. It makes a lot of sense. Guan Yu Zhou, still a higher level than me at the moment. But anyway, we also get both sponsor bonuses, as they're pretty much impossible for us to fail at this point. But yeah, I really wish I didn't sign that zigzag one and got something a bit better. But we'll get our chance to get rid of that at some point soon. But anyway, let's get into the management. So we've got 9 days to fill until the next event. We've got G-Force training for Guan Yu Zhou, then attend F1 Esports event for a boost in driver acclaim. I'm not sure if that's mine or Guan Yu Zhou's, or both of ours potentially. But then secondary sponsor venue opening for the final few days. That will boost our team acclaim. We have enough money to upgrade one of our facilities, so we'll buy the quality control upgrade for the powertrain. Finally, I'll fix this minor ERS upgrade that failed, and other than that, I will say thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time for the French Grand Prix.